Okay, guys. This chicken is just de-thawed. I sprinkled. But there is a beer up this chicken's ass. Not only do we kill chickens, but we mess them up by putting a can of beer up their butts. There is a little beer can up the butt chicken holder there. Bought it for $3. Let's see how it turns out. As you can see, the chicken on the butt's doing pretty good. Got a little stand there, it's holding up. You can see down its throat, you can see the beer can. You can see it coming out though. Well, yeah. Okay, that chicken's cooking pretty good. I did want to share with you, yes, I do have a beer. But it's a little sauce. I crushed up a bay leaf. Bay leaf and chicken, just like, I don't know, it just matches. I put some olive oil in here, Maggi sauce, soy sauce, a tad of Worcester sauce. You want to just be careful with that Worcester. It gets a little tangy taste. But I actually added a little bit of beer and mixed it up, and a few spices like pepper, a little bit of cayenne, spiced it up a little bit. But I'm adding it in here, and I just mix it up, and I cover it by my grill. And as we're cooking, I'll just go ahead and baste it. Keep that meat all juicy. Chicken's taking a shower. So not only does it have a can of Bud Light inside of it, shooting up alcohol and steaming out the top to ensure the meat is real juicy from the inside, but we're also making sure the outside is really getting a good basting. Oh my, look at that damn chicken. Oh, look at the butt. That thing is looking good. I'm gonna check the temperature pretty soon. Oh my, smoke, hickory smoke. That's really good. All the beer in the butt. Basting, this is like the fourth or fifth time. I think, yeah, it's been five times since I basted. It's, you know, you gotta take a shower, you know, you gotta get underneath the armpits right there. You gotta make sure everything's covered. You gotta get all those spices in there. She is looking good. I just hope the temperature's gonna be good. So. Hey guys, we've been cooking for a few hours and I've been basting all the time. I'm talking all the time. We're going to the temperature gauge. Whole chicken like this, 180 degrees, no less. Do not do less. Do not do 165 on a whole chicken like this. There's so many things that can go wrong with a whole chicken like this, and we are pushing one. Uh-oh. We're not doing it. Only at 120. Oh, pushing 140. It's going up slow. But we smoked her. Look at it. Look at it where the temperature gauge tests the bone. The reason why you want the temperature gauge to touch the bone is because the bone is the most inner part of the meat. And the innermost part of the meat is the most frozen. We are only pushing 140 and we're holding. Shoot, I'm gonna get her up. Okay, well, we're gonna have to double time baste it because look at that. That chicken looks done, but it's only at 140. 140, so we can't eat that because once we cut into it, it's gonna be bloody, you know? So we're gonna have to shut her up and cook her a little bit longer. Okay, here we are at 176. 176, we got a few more degrees and we're going to take her off. 176, look at that blood. We got back.